Hello everyone, and welcome to this SAS Explorer Super Demo, SAS and Microsoft 365, an excellent partnership. My name is Sasha Karpinski, and I'm a product manager here at SAS. And also with me today for this demo is Tim Beasy, a principal software developer at SAS. At SAS, we're passionate about making analytics available to everyone, everywhere. And what better way to do that than by bringing the power of SAS to some of the most popular productivity applications today? SAS for Microsoft 365, included with SAS Visual Analytics, allows you to seamlessly access your SAS Viya environment from within familiar Microsoft productivity tools, and leverage insights powered by SAS to take your office documents to the next level. And we really mean analytics everywhere. SAS for Microsoft 365 is available on both web and desktop versions of Microsoft tools, as well as on your Mac. In this demo, you'll see how you can access and interact with your SAS Visual Analytics reports, such as exploring live SAS data using filtering and drill downs, and embedding visual insights into your office documents. Then we'll show you how you can easily work directly with SAS data in your Excel worksheets. With that, let's dive in. Tim, take it away.
Thanks, Sasha. Okay, so now we're back in Excel. And when you have SAS for Microsoft 365, you'll notice a SAS tab show up in your ribbon. You can click on there to see all of the abilities that we add. The first one we're going to show is clicking on Home. This will open our app into a task pane. Once you're authenticated, you will see our app running here inside of Excel, just like all of your other SAS Viya 4 apps would run in a browser. So we're going to start by opening a report. So I'll come to my Reports tab, navigate through some folders here, and choose to open this report. This report will open, and you will see it is a SAS Visual Analytics report, and it will basically behave just like it does on the web in SAS Visual Analytics. The difference is we're displaying it inside of Excel. You can see all your pages are still available. All of the elements are still interactive. They can filter each other. As you go back and forth, everything updates. And you can always come up here to the top menu and say Reopen Report, and we will open it again with the latest and greatest data from SAS. So what we want to do now is get this content into Excel. That's why you're using the add-in, after all. So I want to get this bar chart over here inside of the worksheet. So I will come to the worksheet. There's a little object menu that shows up. I'll click on that and say Insert in Document. And now we'll put this graph inside of your worksheet. There's a lot more space to work with over here. You can see everything's much bigger. And I like nice wide bars on my bar charts. So I'm going to make this a little more squished, but wider here. And then I will update in Document again. When you do that, now that we know what size you want this graph to be, we will generate a new image that fits that size perfectly. So now you can see all of the different types of product category as well as the bars inside of Excel. But Excel is, at its heart, a spreadsheet application. So we want to put some values in the cells here and see how Excel works with those. What we'll do for this is we'll go over to this purchase details, which happens to be a table object, and it is filtered by your warehouse capacity graph over here. So I can click on the California warehouse and see all the values related to that warehouse. Let's get this data inside Excel. I'll click on the object menu and insert it into my document. Once I do, I will see all of the values showing up. And at this point, it is Excel content. It's coming from SAS, but you can do all these cool Excel things with it. Like we can select a row and or a column, put data bars on there. Select another column, and we can put color scale on there. It's the SAS data feeding these values here, but it's Excel doing the formatting and the display. So if I come along after a bit and change to the Georgia warehouse. Say I want to look at that data. I click here, it'll update it in my report in the task pane. But if I click over here and say update in document, now we'll go back to the same place you inserted this table before and update with the new values from SAS and show the same Excel formatting that you had before. So you can swap your data in and out using Excel or using SAS, but get Excel's power of formatting and the application that you know how to use. So let's send this report over to Sasha. I think she'd be interested to see it. Let me open a new email message. Bring that over here, and we'll send it over to her. The add-in, in addition to running inside of Excel, also runs inside of Outlook. You'll see a SAS group on your ribbon here, and if you click on SAS Home, you'll see the same login page here. And after you authenticate, you will see the same task pane displayed in Outlook that you would in Excel. Let's get some more space, and let's start seeing what we can do with this message. In addition to displaying this task pane inside email messages, it is also supported inside of appointments. So since I've recently opened this report, I can click on it here, and we'll open that same report over here in the task pane. And it will remember my state. It knows that I was looking at the Georgia warehouse and that I had the purchase details active. The first thing I want to do is insert a link to this report so that Sasha can click on that link and very quickly get directly to this report inside of Visual Analytics. But I also think she's interested in this purchase history. This is a cool chart, and I want to insert it directly in the message. So we'll put that in there, and now we can just see this report. If you're working with an appointment, maybe this is the chart you want to talk about in your meeting, so you can insert that and send it out to everybody. Now there's a lot of different elements in this report, and I don't want to insert them all into the email message. So I may want to attach the report as a PDF. I can click up here and choose Attach Report as PDF. This will generate a PDF, the same like we would in SAS Visual Analytics. You can change some different options about how you generate the PDF. And when you click OK, we will generate the PDF, and then we will attach it to this email message. Okay, it's attached, and we're ready to go. So I'm going to click Send and send this email over to Sasha. Sasha, can you open your Outlook and check out this email I just sent you?
Yep, Tim, I would love that. All right, so I've got Outlook pulled up. Let me open the email that I just got from Tim. Right away, you'll see the link to the Visual Analytics report, the embedded content down below, and then the PDF that Tim generated. So let's have a look at that. So we can look at the PDF, see the several different pages that the report contains, as well as all of the visual insights. Basically identical to what you just saw in Excel and Outlook. The next thing I want to do is pull up the SAS pane on my end. So the cool thing here is that once I open the SAS pane in Outlook, any linked reports in my email will automatically load to the Results tab. So this makes it super easy for me to start digging into this report immediately as soon as Tim sends it over. So hopefully you can see how powerful this is in bringing analytic-driven insights to users where they work every single day. And to bring these insights to an even wider audience, SAS for Microsoft 365 will also soon provide integration with PowerPoint. So we'll give you a sneak peek of that in the breakout session, but for now, Tim, why don't we show what we can do while working with SAS data?
You bet. Back to Excel. So this time I want to open some data and add it to my worksheet. To do that, I'm going to go to the Data tab, and from here I can choose to look through all of my compute libraries that are defined, or I can go to my CAS libraries. For this example, I want to go into CAS. I'll go to my public folder and open this EndWave Sales Detail dataset. That shows us information about the data set over here in the task pane. I can see that there's a little over 1,000 rows, which isn't a lot in the grand scheme of data, but it's still a lot of rows to look at one point in time. So I can choose some options about this data. We'll put some row numbers in there. We'll display the table name and any filters with it. And I'll go ahead and insert this into the worksheet. Once I do that, we'll see the data show up. And you can see once we get the data in here, there are indeed just 100 rows being shown. I'll scroll to the bottom and show you that. You can go to the ribbon and we can go to the next page and see the next 100 rows of data. So using this next and previous page buttons, you can navigate forwards and backwards through your data to find the information that you want in a reasonable size. And at any point in time, you can always choose your start row and how many rows you wish to insert at one point in time. Click update and we will update with just that number of rows. This data has a lot of columns as well, columns that I'm not even sure what they mean, and so I want to trim them out of what I'm inserting into the worksheet. To do that, I'll go to the Columns tab. I'll clear all the columns, and I'll just pick a few that I'm really interested in. I will put some information about the customer, the product that they are looking to purchase, how much they paid. I can click Update again, and that'll bring down a much smaller set of data into the worksheet. Just the columns that I had selected. It's still now SAS data, but it's being displayed in Excel. So I can do those cool things that Excel lets you do, like put formulas in here. And I'm going to reference my data from SAS. So I'm going to see a formula where it equals the cost of the unit minus what they paid for it. And then by filling that formula down, I can see which sales maybe were on discount or people may have overpaid for some. It gives me more information from the data that we're importing to the worksheet. Now, once I have this here, I may want to filter this even more. I may want to look into just one specific product category. So to do that, I'll go to the Filter tab. And from here, I can choose an expression builder where I can type in some SQL, but my SQL's not that good, so I want to go to a graphical builder where I can do a point and click to find some information. So in this case, I'm interested in the product category, so I'll choose that column for my filter. I'll click this filter button, and I can add my condition here. Well, I want it to be equal to one of the different values there. Since I may not know all the values in product category, I can click on this lookup button, which will show the distinct values from that column. I do consider myself a man of leisure, so I will click on that and say OK. When I click update here again, you'll see that all of the rows that are returned are now for men leisure. This is great. It's showing me exactly what I want, and all my formulas that I added with Excel are still being applied just to the latest and greatest SAS data that we're providing. But when it comes to buying clothes, I do consider myself kind of cheap, so I want to find the cheapest clothes first. So we'll go over here and add a sort. I'll click Add Sort, choose the column I want to sort on. I'll choose Product Category. And this goes back to the SAS data on the server and sorts the values and then just returns the first 50 here. So when I click update for the last time here, we will see all of the cheapest products get displayed right at the top. And that is how we can take data from SAS and bring it down into Excel so you can use the power of SAS with the formatting power and layout of Excel. It's really the best of both worlds. One additional thing that I did not show you today was how you can get data from Excel up to SAS. That is our upload data feature, and I will be talking about that more in our breakout session for SAS and Microsoft 365, an excellent partnership. That's all I've got. Sasha, would you like to close it out with a few comments?
You've just seen how you can get the best of both worlds by accessing the power of SAS directly from your favorite Microsoft applications. Whether it's embedding SAS content into your Excel worksheets or PowerPoint presentations, or sharing insights from SAS with your colleagues via Outlook, SAS for Microsoft 365 really tries to expand the reach of analytics to help everyone in your organization achieve better business insights. I hope this demo has inspired you to see how SAS can take your office documents to the next level. Thank you, and we'll see you next time. Bye.